good afternoon. Is Travis home already? I've been trying to reach him, but he hasn't returned any of my calls.
He's not at home yet. Maybe he's still at swimming practice.
But the practices are in the morning. I wonder where he could be.
Maybe he went to see someone, but don't worry. I'll tell him you called, okay?
All right. Thank you. Bye.
Madam, sir, are you ready to order?
We haven't decided what we wanted.
Okay, sir. We'll just order later. Take your time, sir.
I just want to make it clear to you. I decided to go with you so you'd stop pestering me.
It's okay. At least you're here. That's one big step. Who knows? Maybe we'll be friends after we share a meal together. Why did you choose this place? We always come here after class. Aren't you tired of their food? Why don't we go to the mall instead?
What? I don't want to go too far. What is this, a date?
Where did you grow up?
Why do you need to know that?
What's wrong with getting to know each other better? It's just a simple question. Not a very personal one anyway.
Okay.
Do you come from a small town?
Why do you think that?
Because I'll always remember that accent of yours that night when you asked me to leave. Do you remember? Me? I'm also from a small town. I stowed away on a ship to the city. Have you ever been on a ship before?
Isn't that Travis's car?
Yes, it is.
Come on, let's go inside.
So, why so quiet all of a sudden? Please say something.
I thought we were just here to eat. Why haven't we ordered something?
One last question. Do you know what a bokknat is? Jasmine, don't you have anything to say to me? I want to know the truth. Jasmine, please. You have to tell me.
Travis, there's something you need to know. I have to be going. Travis!
Oh, Camille.
There you are. I've been looking for you all day. Why aren't you answering your cell phone?
I'm sorry. It's been set on silent mode the whole time. That's why I didn't notice that you were calling me.
Oh, that's okay. I was just worried about you. Hold on. What are you doing here?
Eating. What else?
Alone?
Why not?
Okay.
Hi, sir. Are you and your companion ready to order?
Well, Camille, are you ready to order?
All right.
Oh, here, you choose.
I'm sorry, but I have to go.
Oh, Travis, I thought we were going to eat.
I just remembered. I have a lot of things to do. See you.
See you later.
Later. What is it now?
Hey, you have to learn to be calm. Your temper tantrums are not going to help you.
How can I stay calm? October's next week. It's almost
January
time.
January is still far off. You and Jasmine still have so much time left together. Here,
Here. But...
What's wrong with you? You're too paranoid. You agree to go out with Travis, and then you walk out on him?
Camille and Bruce suddenly arrived. I didn't want to fight with them anymore. Besides, what if Camille sees me with Travis? I'm sure that it'll reach my mother. She gave me very strict orders not to go near Travis. I thought it best just to leave him there.
Is that right? This relationship has too many people. There's Camille, then your mother. If it's this complicated, you should have refused to go out with Travis in the first place.
You're right about that.
Why did you go out?
I already told you, he made me do it.
I know you very well. If you didn't like to go, you wouldn't. Nobody can force you. But the truth of the matter is, you do like him too, correct? Tell me, I know I'm right. You wanted to go out with him. Admit it to me already. You like him. No, you're in love with him.
Yes, you may be right. I think I love him.
What did you say? Did I hear you right? You admit you love him?
I do.
Finally! No more denials. She loves him. You love him.
Shh, be quiet, Romeo.
Great. My heart is beating wildly. So, this means that you will allow Travis to court you. But what about your rival, Camille?
I don't know right now. I'm so confused.
Isn't Travis quite strange? He's a bit of a loner. Imagine not wanting to have the pleasure of our company.
Maybe he already had a date. Didn't you notice what the waiter asked him? He asked if he and his companion were ready to order.
So what? He was probably referring to us.
I don't know. I have a feeling about this.
Who would he date? We're the only ones he really knows.
Mother? What do you know about Bianca? I mean, how well do you know her?
Well, I just met her. I don't really know her that well.
But you're always together with her. So, what does she want? You must know what she likes. What type of music? What type of food? What does she do?
I don't know. I hardly talk to her. I just know that she's into, photography.
Photography?
Yes.
Well, Bianca, how are you and Brandon? What did you talk about?
Nothing much. Life in America and how different it is back here. Just small talk.
So you're getting along fine, right? You have many similar experiences. You could develop an attraction for each other.
Stop. What's with the questions? Do you like her?
Come on, Mother. I mean, she's okay.
Listen, Brandon, I won't allow that. Leave her alone.
But why? I mean, she's a nice girl.
Exactly. She is a nice girl. And I know how you are with girls. You'll only break her heart.
Clara, just because we have common interests does not mean we'll get along. Besides, we approach life differently.
That shouldn't be a problem. And you can always look the other way. Don't think if Brandon courts you, just say yes at once,
I just broke up with my boyfriend, you know. We were about to get married, remember? Also, I'm not ready to date again.
You're such a fool. This is the best way to forget all the bad experiences you had with your ex-boyfriend.
Mother, come on. I haven't even done anything, yet you're overreacting. I just want to get to know her, that's all.
No, get over it. Get to know somebody else, not her.
Brandon is a very good catch. His family's very rich.
I'm not looking for material things in a relationship. There must be love, Clara.
That's why men always take advantage of you, because you don't use your head. Like I've always told George and Camille, love is not going to put food on the table. You have to be practical too.
Money was never that important to me, especially in a relationship.
Bianca, you're too emotional. If you don't want to use your head, I'll do the thinking for you, like I've always done. Just give Brandon a chance, and I know you'll never regret it.
Don't forget, Clara is my best friend. And if you ever hurt Bianca, it will affect my friendship with her, especially our business relationship. There are lots of girls out there. Find another one. Leave Bianca alone. Wait, have you seen Travis?
I'm asking for your help, Mother. Yet Travis is still the one on your mind. Check the pool. His body might be floating in it.
Jasmine! Where were you earlier?
In Romeo's house.
Were you with Travis?
Travis? Why would you think we would be together?
Make sure you stay away, or you'll be answering to me!
Jasmine?
Travis, what's wrong with you? What are you doing here?
Our afternoon date didn't push through. How about a midnight snack?
You're not thinking. We can do a snack any time during the day, not when everyone's asleep. Why don't you go home?
Jasmine, give me a break. I really worked hard for this surprise. It's not far away.
You're really hard-headed. I just said no. What if my mother wakes up?
You should know me by now, Jasmine. I don't take no for an answer. I am not leaving until you come with me.
Or I can wake your mother up and ask her...
Shh! You always put me in a spot. Go home.
Please?
Is this really necessary?
It's a surprise. All my efforts will go to waste if you saw it before we got there.
Let's make it quick, okay?
Don't worry. We're already here. Surprise! Be careful. It's still a bit hot. I'd like to continue our conversation earlier. You haven't answered any of my questions. So where'd you grow up? Huh, Jasmine? Have you ever ridden a ship? Do you know what walnut means?
There seems to be something on your mind. Why don't you just say it?
Okay. I'll ask you straight. Are you Boknut? Or aren't you?
Why do you keep saying Boknut? Didn't you just forget about her in your life? Jasmine?
Forgot about her? Maybe I changed that too. But what did I do?
What are you mumbling about? I suppose you feel guilty about all the things you did to her.
So you do know Boknut. You're her.
I didn't say I was Boknut. This conversation's over.
Jasmine. Hold on. We're not done. We don't have much time left. I know it'll be hard for you to believe what I'm about to tell you right now. This is our second chance to love again.
What are you talking about? What you're saying is just confusing me more. What are you both doing out here? Jasmine, come with me. Let's go home. As for you, Travis, stay away from my daughter. What you're doing is only causing more trouble for us. Let's go.
Madam Emily.
Hurry. Why did you meet that boy in the middle of the night? What kind of girl are you? How long have you been sneaking off like this?
Mother, this is the first time. Travis just wanted to talk to me.
Just talk? There's a picnic spread complete with candles and flowers. It's obvious he's courting you.
No. He isn't. Please believe me. He just wanted to say something.
Didn't we have a clear understanding that you would keep away from that boy?
I really tried to stay away from him, but he insists on following me. I haven't done anything wrong.
Following you around or even coming here, you shouldn't encourage him. You are not supposed to be with him. You've been lying to me. I can no longer trust what you tell me. From now on, I want you home directly from school. I don't want this to happen again.
Jasmine. Jasmine, listen to me. Jasmine, I'm sorry about last night. Jasmine. Are you all right? Jasmine, I know I got you into trouble. I'm so sorry. Jasmine, I'm begging you, please. Please, let's not fight each other again. Please.
Don't worry, Travis. We won't fight anymore. Because from now on, we will never talk to each other.
I'm so happy, Monica. Our families seem destined to get closer with each other. Mm-hmm. Camille and Travis, they're getting along so well. And now, Brandon and my sister are a pair.
Well, yes, I'm so happy for Camille and Travis. But for Brandon and Bianca, I have some concerns about them.
Monica, you have such a low regard for your son.
That's not what I meant. I'm just telling it as it is. I know how my son feels. I've never seen Brandon serious with a girl. In time, he might break Bianca's heart. And then our friendship will suffer.
Don't be so paranoid, Monica. Who knows? Bianca might be able to change Brandon. If you ask me, I'm hopeful about their relationship.
Well, I hope so too.
Travis, why do you keep looking and staring at our maid? What is it with you? Are you in love with her? Well, why can't you answer me?
Camille. It looks like you and Travis have something more important to discuss other than what I have to teach.
No, we don't, madam.
Okay, then. If that's the case, pay attention.
What are you doing here back so soon?
We had fun the last time we were together, so I was thinking about hanging out. I'm sure you'll enjoy the pleasure of my company.
Wow, how confident! For your information, if it weren't for my sister, I would have walked out on you on that day.
Well, I don't see your sister anywhere, Bianca. But you're still here. So that would mean you also like me.
You know, you're right. My sister is not here. So, goodbye.
I'm glad that we had this time to talk. I've thought about it carefully. And I've decided not to leave Clara. I can't bear to leave Camille.
That's good. You made the right decision. It's for everyone's benefit.
But I don't know how much longer I can take Clara.
You said it yourself, George. You're doing this for Camille's sake. Her health is fragile. You leaving Clara might be too much.
Excuse me. Travis! Huh? Come on, let's go out. It's been a long time since we last went out together.
Oh, right now? Not today, Camille. I've got a lot of reviewing to do. So, I have to go, but next time I promise. I'm sorry. Jasmine?
Travis, stop it, please.
Jasmine, listen to what I have to say, please.
No, you listen to me. Travis, stay away from me. I don't want any more trouble. I'm begging you to leave me alone.
Jasmine, I know you must have some feelings for me too.
I don't have any other feelings for you, except anger. Get out of my sight. You're trying to steal Travis away from me! Who, me? Why would I do that to you? What do you mean you wouldn't? I saw you talking to him! It was Travis who kept talking to me. You liar! Camille! Jasmine! What's wrong with the both of you, huh?
Emily, it's Jasmine's fault. She's so unfair. We already don't get along, yet she's making it more difficult by trying to steal Travis.
Jasmine.
Mother, that's not true. I'm not stealing Travis from her. And another thing, you don't own him for me to steal him from you. You see that? She is stealing Travis away.
Camille, that's enough. Remember your condition. You might have a heart attack. Jasmine, go to your room this instant. Go now! Hush, Camille. It's all right. Camille.
Will you discipline your daughter, Emily? Just because you're George's relatives does not mean you can abuse your stay. She has no respect, no morals.
I've been talking to my daughter about all this, madam. But please, don't scold her that way. Jasmine is not like that.
You're the same! You have the nerve to answer me back! I can throw you both out in the street! George may be your cousin, I'm not. I'm your employer, and you're just servants in this house!
Yes, madam.
Thank you, mother.
As for you, Camille, how many times do I have to tell you, but it doesn't sink in? Why do you always lose out to our maid?
It's not that I'd like to lose out to her. I always try to do my best.
Is that so? This is your best? You're not losing out? So all this just means that you're the biggest loser in all this.
You shouldn't have done that. Didn't I ask you to stay away from Travis? Look what happened. The situation's become worse. Madame Claire is now involved in all this. Poor Camille has to suffer through it.
It's always Camille. Why do you always have to take Camille's side? I'm your daughter, mother. Why can't you believe in what I tell you? Why can't you believe that I'm innocent in all of this, mother?
Okay, Jasmine. Even if you aren't guilty, in her eyes, Camille thinks you're wrong. Jasmine, she was the first one to meet Travis over you.
No, mother.
They've been friends for quite some time. Jasmine, stop it. You know that even when Travis was in America, they were already friends. Let Camille have him. Her illness might worsen if this situation causes too much anxiety for her.
Camille's illness was always the reason. It hasn't changed. When we were kids, I had to give in to everything she did. But mother, how much longer am I supposed to do that?
Jasmine, I realize it's difficult. But please believe me. You have to keep away from Travis. Leave the both of them alone.
You've always been telling me to stay away from them. but you never tell me the reason why. Mother. Mother is always mad at me. It's because of Jasmine. This is all her fault. I hate her. I hate her.
What? You're only second, Honor? You're probably slacking off. Playing around the whole day.
I've been studying hard, Mother. That's how I was able to get second, Honor.
What that really means is that someone else is first. You're only second best. You're not going to get anywhere in life, Camille, if you always end up second.
What is it? What is it?
Yes, Mother.
Wow, Jasmine. Your grades are outstanding. You really got first honor?
Yes, Mother.
I'm so proud of you.
Jasmine edged you out? She's first honor? Our maid's daughter is smarter than you? I'm so disappointed, Camille.
Camille, would you like some chocolate? Where did you buy that?
I didn't. Mother gave it to me as a prize because I got first honor.
Don't like it. Tastes bad.
We just finished our quarterly exams at school. Why are you still studying? You must be reading ahead, huh? That's really smart. No wonder you're always in the honor roll. Luckily, I'm in the honor roll too. I hope I can stay in the honor roll so I can get a college scholarship. I dream of becoming a lawyer someday. It's my wish. What about you?
What's wrong with you? Can't you see I'm studying? You're so noisy and talkative.
Sorry, Camille.
Sorry.
Hi, Camille.
Will you leave me alone?
Come on, Camille. Let's play.
I said no. Will you stop bothering me?
Why are you raising your voice at me? Are you mad at me?
What do you think? You better leave. I don't like you anymore.
Camille?
Go away!
Letters!
What is it?
There's a letter for Pocknut. Does she live here? There's no surname indicated on the letter.
That's mine.
Camille, I thought I heard the postman ring at the gate. Is there a letter for me?
He didn't. Will you go back to your house?
Dear Pocknut, I'm sorry I have not written in a while. My father has been bringing me to see many new places. We went vacationing with my new mother and new brother in a faraway place. I had to ride an airplane again. I could not find the time to write you until now. I know I promised to keep in touch. I'm sorry. Don't get mad. This won't happen again. Promise. I will always write from now on. By the way, what's your real name? Father said, it would be better for us to know our full names to make sure we receive our letters. I'm Travis Johnson. What about you? What is your real name?
Camille? I think you left this outside. What's that you're hiding? Will you show it to me? Camille, give it to me. Let me see. You have a friend in America, Camille? Wonderful. Dear Bokbok, my real given name is Camille Soriano.
But, Mother, I'm not the real Boknat. It's Jasmine who's the one. She's the real friend of Bokbok, not me.
So what? You are a better match for this Travis Johnson than Jasmine will ever be. And another thing, this is good for my business. And if you keep writing to this Travis boy, I will be able to introduce myself to his parents. They can be our prospective clients. I can sell them properties. And I can buy you a lot of toys and new clothes. Don't you want that? You'd make your mother very happy, and I'll be able to buy whatever your heart desires.
Okay then, if that's what you want, Mother. But what about Jasmine? What if she writes Bokbok again?
Let me take care of Jasmine. Just go ahead, Camille. Write to him. Here, just take the pen. Write this down. Dear Bokbok, you know, my real name is Camille Soriano. Yes, Monica. When we start planning our vacation in the summer, we'll surely visit your family in America. And I'll be able to show you some real estate properties we can invest on. It'll make a nice retirement investment for you and Randy. Yes, yes, Monica. Yes, okay. I will call you again with our final vacation plans. Say hello to Travis for me, and also from my daughter, Camille. All right, Monica, bye. Jasmine?
Madam?
Come here. This letter came, but I don't know who it's for. And because the name was quite vague, I opened it. But Camille told me that you are this, Bokna?
Yes, I am.
Here then, you may keep the letter.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
You thought you could put one over me, Jasmine? You don't know this, but I'm well ahead of you. I've taken Travis away from you a long time ago. And no matter what, I will never return him. Never!
Mr. Andres?
Huh? What is it?
Oh, nothing. I'm sorry.
Actually, Clara, I really don't regret losing Mr. Morita's business because of what had happened. I'm more worried about you and George. You had a fight because of it.
Forget about it, Monica. Because we're both fine now. George doesn't hold grudges against me. I was also able to set another meeting with Mr. Morita, so we can fix this problem. But, Monica, I think you should worry about something more important.
What is it?
I don't know how to say this nicely, but, your son Travis has been seeing our maid, Jasmine.
I thought he was seeing Camille.
Oh, I thought so too. But it seems like he's going out with our maid as well.
Jasmine and Travis? Don't get me wrong, Clara. I'm not a social snob. But, I'm not rejecting Jasmine just because she's your maid.
Of course not, Monica. I agree. I am not a social snob either.
But I wonder what Travis was thinking. Courting two girls living in the same place. But how is Camille? How's she taking it? Did she have another attack?
Not really. But she did have chest pains when she learned about Travis and Jasmine last night.
Okay, don't worry. Leave it to me. I'll talk to Travis about all of this. I have to talk to him to find out what happened. Initially, I thought I would have problems with Brandon and Bianca. I was mistaken. It's Travis.
Monica, I don't have a problem with Brandon. In fact, he is with Bianca right now.
I didn't expect to see you today, after what happened last time.
Actually, my sister forced me to see you.
Well, all I can say about that is, your sister has good taste. Please. Don't go. I know we got off the wrong foot here. I can't blame you. I made a bad first impression on you. But Bianca, I want you to understand I'm not like that. I'm much more than that. So, can we start over? Please? I'm Brandon.
Bianca, but this doesn't change anything, okay?
Bianca, I hope we can put behind the bad first impression you have of me.
And what about the second impression? And the third? The fourth? And fifth? You don't have any respect for your mother. You're always fighting with her. And you've given her a lot of grief. You think you're never wrong. And you act as if you're a blessing to women.
First of all, I never wanted to fight my mother. It just so happens that it's been that way. There are things beyond our control. Bianca, you know, if you were in my shoes, then you would see what kind of problems I have with my family. You don't know how my mother has not been taking care of me. She criticizes everything that I do because I don't agree to what she wants. Do you know how that feels, Bianca? Believe it or not, I don't have any confidence in women. This arrogance that you see in me is my defense mechanism, so I don't get hurt. I guess I come on too strong. But if you want to know the truth, everything is just an act. It's me pretending to be cool, but deep down inside, I know I'm not. Bianca, if I've done anything to offend you, I'm sorry. For everything that I've done, I'm sorry.
Okay, Brandon. I'm willing to forget all the bad impressions I have of you. Fresh start?
Come on, food's getting cold.
Okay. Let's eat.
All right.
Travis, before you say anything, please listen to me. Stop already. You're making a big mess of my life.
Why do you say that? Because of Camille?
It's everything. I've had enough. This whole thing is confusing me.
And what about your heart? Is it also confused? Jasmine, do you love me? I won't give up. Everything I will do for you. Whatever it is, Jasmine. Anything.
If you really mean what you just said, then do the one thing I ask of you. Leave me alone, Travis.